Hey guys, it's Mackenzie. Welcome back to my channel. So today I have a huge cumulative thrift outlet haul to share. Today we have over 90 items to get through. This is probably around 4 to 5 thrift trips. I shop at both the Goodwill outlet, otherwise known as the Goodwill bins here in Houston, where I pay $2.19 per pound. I also shop at the Family Thrift Center outlet where I pay $2 per item. So each of the things you will see in this haul, I paid right around that $2 mark. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get into it. We do have, I think, about 14 pairs of shoes to start off with. And then we will move into clothing. So starting off with a personal favorite here. These are so cute. They're like a slip-on mule with this, is that a cross stitch or needlepoint? I can never remember which one, but gaiters, adorable. And then I believe this is a genuine leather trim. The brand is Stitches Galore. This is the bottom sole. They just say size medium, so I'll probably have to measure and try them on and kind of try to gauge what size they are. Next, we have a pair of sandals. I just grabbed these from the bins because they look like they were really nice quality. This strappy upper here is genuine suede. They say made in Italy. I think actually everything is leather, size 39. This has always been a great sandal brand for me. Well, they make more than sandals. I've sold their boots before for around $55. Neot. They're made in Israel. It's kind of like almost like a Birkenstock type shoe. And these should sell for, I would say, 35 to 38-ish. I really like these. They're colorful. They have a little bit of a platform to them. Once again, very high quality. This is the bottom sole. And they are a size 40. Next, another bins pickup. I mainly got these because, once again, genuine suede, and I also thought they were really cute. Kind of a preppy chic look with this blush upper and bow detail, small heel and back, and they were a really good size. They're size 9.5. Another fun pair, these are Dolce Vita. Dolce Vita does have lines within the brand. DV, if you just see DV, those are sold at Target. This is the higher tier portion of the brand. And really fun, just kind of slip-on loafer style shoes. This is a genuine calf hair back with a leopard print and kind of like a cognac leather upper. It says man-made / calf hair upper. So I'm guessing that this part is man-made. This part's calf hair. These are a size 8.5. They are the Kelsa shoes. Great shape. This was an exciting find. These were also from the bins. They are Stuart Weitzman, if you can see in there. Heeled booties, just an everyday black pair of booties with a stacked heel and back. Amazing shape here. I always look at this portion here to see what has been taken out of the sole, and they are definitely going strong. These are, they're made in Spain, and they are a size 7.5. We have some Minnetonka boots. I do love selling boots like these. I've sold a couple pairs now for, I want to say, for 50 to around 75-ish, so I'll probably expect about 65-ish for these. Fringe going all the way down with this kind of braided concho detail. They do zip on the insides for easy on off, and these are a size 7 or 8, I'm not sure, there's two numbers there, and they were stuffed when I found them at the store, so we love that. Next up, we have Lucky Brand sandals. This is a definite consistent shoe seller for me. Lucky Brand shoes sell great. These are the Hipsta sandals in a size 8.5. Genuine suede upper with this lace-up detail, kind of a faux wood platform, and once again in pretty good condition. Tried and true brand here. This is Clarks. Some people only wear Clarks. They are a very reputable shoe brand known for quality and good materials. I definitely don't pick up all Clarks, but I thought these would be an excellent kind of staple spring, summer shoe for someone. They're neutral, suede upper. They have this nice cork wedge to them. These are a size 8. More Dolce Vita. Once again, this is that higher tier to the brand. And I just thought these were really cool. They're very boho, but still kind of like 90s mod style with the square toe. They are genuine leather upper, size 8.5. My other favorite consistent shoe seller, these are Steve Madden. Adorable reptile booties. This is, I believe, yeah, leather upper. They're the Brave style in a size 7.5. Love the neutral kind of color scheme to them. They zip on the interior and they have this chunky heel. Okay, last couple pairs of shoes. LL Bean, once again, kind of like Clarks, a very reputable brand. People know it, they love it. And I just thought these were great. I picked these up for $2. They're genuine suede upper, like a faux shearling, and then the bottom sole looked really good. I don't like to pick up shoes that have this shearling lining unless they are in amazing condition, which these are. They're a size women's 9. And I did save the best for last. I didn't mean to, but here they are. These are YSL lamb leather espadrilles. So I picked these up for $2 at the Family Thrift Center outlet. I am like 99% confident that they are genuine or authentic. I have tried to authenticate them on 2 different authentication sites, but the reading keeps coming back undetermined because a lot of the information has been kind of rubbed off from wear. You probably can't really even see it, but you can't read anything that it says. But all of the markings and stitching and materials are all extremely high quality. This is the Saint Laurent kind of logo there on the bottom. There is not one stitch out of place. They just look so high quality. So I would be shocked if they were fake. This leather is incredibly soft and supple. So I'm not sure what I will do with those. I'm going to have to get them authenticated. I would never in a million years sell something that I'm not fully 100% on. We will see. I will keep you guys updated on those. Those are a size, I think they're a size, yeah, 36.5, if you're wondering. I'm pretty sure, yeah, 36.5. Okay, we have one bag. So cool. I sold a bag kind of similar to this in the past. I want to say for around 55-ish. It's a leather bag that has, it's like, I guess you'd say tooling there, hand tooling, and a floral design. It opens like this, and then you have a pretty large interior, definitely more than enough room for all of the essentials, and it's in pretty good shape. There is some kind of surface scratching, but you know, no flaws to the leather at all. This is a blanket scarf. You guys know these are my bread and butter in the cooler weather months, and this is a very classic kind of colorway. It has the fringe trim. I did get this from the bins. It's Victoria's Secret. It looks brand new. It actually still has the tag kind of barb on it, which I think would be kind of uncomfortable, you know, to keep on. So, and it really looks like it hasn't ever been worn. So I would imagine this was pretty expensive. It looks very intricate. You have the bra and then this kind of like corset thing. I don't know what you call these. I need to do some research on this. But yeah, I'll probably list this. I'm not sure. I've done no research, but I'm guessing for at least 35-ish. One children's item, this adorable little leopard open front cardigan. I could not leave this behind. You guys know I'm a sucker for leopard print. Hayden girls, size 9-10. Okay, now we will move into women's and men's clothing, mostly women's. First off is this BCB generation faux fur vest in a size extra small, small. This is nice for transitional weather, you know, in the springtime. You can throw this on and it's very chic, but it keeps you kind of warm with some ventilation as well. This was an amazing find. This is, I believe, a genuine 1970s vintage dress. The brand is Miss Elliott, California. And it does have a paper tag here as well as a, well, actually I thought it had the union tag there, but either way, those tags clued me into it being vintage, and then I did go to vintagefashionguild.org to date the tag, and I was able to date it that way. So yeah, it's from the 70s, and I mean, this thing is flawless, and it is gorgeous. So it has this all-over multicolored floral print with a paisley at the trims, so at the wrist, and then at the bottom hem. I did model this just because it's so flattering and I feel like you don't get the full effect with it just on the hanger. The belt is so cute. It's like a, I am showing this so poorly. So the belt is like a kind of rainbow color, like stripe, and it kind of ties in with the paisley print. I could not get over this. I listed it pretty high, I think for around $100, just because it is vintage and it is in such great condition. And it's really a statement piece. Beautiful dress there. Okay, next we have Anthropology. This is Moth. And I picked this up for multiple reasons. So first off, it is a cashmere blend, 10% cashmere. It's super soft feeling. It's in great condition, no pilling. And then of course you have this adorable style to it. It's called the French knot cardigan because it does have all of these French knots on it in like a multicolored print. A few of them are metallic, and I just thought this was precious. It's a size small. Kind of switching gears over to a grungy find. This is Harley Davidson and size extra, extra large. I believe this was men's originally, but I did list it in my women's closet because I thought it'd be so cute to wear oversized with like biker shorts. I love the all over bleach effect, and it is a Carson City, Nevada graphic. Next up, going back to a tried and true kind of brand for a lot of people, this is J. Jill. I do love picking up J. Jill, specifically their Love Linen line, because people do love linen. They have this faux wood button detail on both sides. I think they're a high rise pull on pant with an elastic back. So yeah, really nice pair of pants here. They're size medium tall, which was another great aspect to them. You know, there are a lot of people that wear tall size clothing, and I'm sure it's a little bit harder to find. Next up, we have Altered State, size medium, very boho piece here. It's a peasant style blouse with a tie at the chest and a little tassel detail. It does have beading around the collar, which is really pretty, and then a bell sleeve. So I loved this. I thought that was like really high quality for Altered State, which is kind of like a mid-tier boutique brand. Chico's, this is the same kind of thing as J. Jill. I don't get everything I find, but I did think this was really cute. It's a long line open front vest. This is, again, a great piece for springtime, upcoming springtime. The color palette is definitely kind of springy, and it's a short sleeve, but does provide some warmth. It has a fringe trim, so I will add, you know, boho and all kinds of keywords to this. It's a size 3, which I think, I want to say that's extra large in Chico's. Moving on, we have Rag & Bone, which is a very expensive brand. This shirt probably retailed for like $150, if not a little bit more. It's a really nice minimalist contemporary cut with this boxy bodice contrast, white buttons, and then this all over crinkle texture. This is a size large. Another tried and true brand. I would say these are J. Jill, Talbots, Chico's, Eileen Fisher, Soft Surroundings. They're all more mature brands. And if you find them with a good material or a really substantial kind of style, they sell extremely well. So this is a pure merino wool sweater dress in a really pretty green color. It has a V-neck and then this flounce sleeve. It is a little bit longer length. I think this is a midi dress, and yeah, 100% merino wool. So really pretty, great quality. Going back to our trendy finds, this is We The Free from Free People, size 28. Just a cutoff denim mini skirt with distressing. I got this to list and add keywords like rodeo, western, springtime. A lot of people are going to the rodeo and they are on the hunt for outfits. Okay, next, this is a boutique brand, Olivaceous. This was a Ben's grab. I got it because I just thought it was adorable. It's like a patchwork floral printed dress. It has a smocked chest, so you can wear the shoulders kind of how you want, off shoulder or up higher. And we have a bell sleeve. I just basically loved the print combined with the cut. It's a size large. Soft surroundings, size medium. I like to stick to size large and up with soft surroundings in combination with a nice cut or print. But even though this is more plain, it is new without tags. And so I did want to go ahead and get it. It's a great closet staple for someone. And it is a really nice soft stretch jersey knit, which is super wearable. That's just a polyester, viscose, and spandex blend. So really nice. And I do like that really pretty blue color to it. Next up, I loved this find. It's just Romans, which I don't think is anything special, but the, is that focusing? Yeah, there we go. The fact that this is a size 3X, it's a super substantial cut, and it's textured in this green velvet. I had to get this. It's a V-neck long line midi or maxi dress, I forget right now, and then the bottom hem does have a ruffle to it. It's a high-low. This green velvet is just beautiful, and like I said, 3X. I love finding more substantial plus size items. I do like to have every size in my closet. A graphic t-shirt here. This is Nirvana with a multicolored print to it. I always get band tees size large. They fly out of my closet for, I would say, 25 to 30-ish, and they sell very quickly. More Anthropologie, Angel of the North. This is actually one of my favorite sub-brands to find from Anthropologie. They have a lot of really pretty knits and sweaters, jackets. This is no exception. It's, let me see if I can situate it a little better here. It's like this nubby material, long line cardigan with a chevron kind of textured print to it. This is the back. You can see it a little bit better. And this is also a wool blend. It's size extra small petite. a fun vintage pickup, Bill Blass. I love finding vintage Bill Blass vintage items. Anything in a denim dress cut from Bill Blass sells especially well. Size 10, light wash, button down, collared dress. How precious is this? It has pockets. It has like the tortoiseshell buttons. And again, I will add like Western rodeo Chico's, back to Chico's, size 3. You will notice in this haul that I have a lot of the, like I was mentioning a little bit ago, the more mature brands. They have been selling so well for me. So, you know, whatever I notice selling really well, I just try to pick up more of it. So I do have a lot of Chico's happening. This is a size 3, which again, I think is extra large. And it's this cheetah print button down shirt. It has chest pockets here. I think this is called like the silky soft cargo pocket button down. Yeah, it's a modal blend. So if you guys aren't familiar with modal, it's the softest material on the planet. So this is like the best of both worlds because it's soft and silky, but it's not, you know, high maintenance like actual silk. And it also has spandex to it, so it has, you know, some stretch for comfort. Okay, next, kind of like Banties, this item is something that also just always kind of flies out of my closet. It's a jumper slash pinafore style mini dress in a denim material. It's also kind of like an overall cut, so yeah, I'm expecting this to sell super quickly. Size 4. It's like a dark gray. Another plus size piece. I just got this because, you know, like I was saying, I like to have all sizes in my closet. I don't think that this is anything expensive, size 1X, but I thought it would be a nice bundle piece. It's a button down gingham print blouse with a little chest pocket. Gingham print is still very trendy. So next we have a bundle of 2 pairs of shorts. I did get these at the bins, and I mainly got them because there were 2. So they're both Wild Fable, size large, and they are a linen blend. So I thought these would be great summer shorts. They have a ruffled trim. How fun is this print? And then this one is the exact same in black. So with them having that linen blend, that definitely does elevate the quality just a bit. Really chic find here. BCBG Max Azria silk blend dress. So pretty. I don't buy all of this brand by any means, but I did love this piece. I think it looks so flattering with this kind of ruching here, and you have some fraying to a lot of the edges, which gives definitely some added interest. Keyhole opening in back, and then it zips down. It's fully lined, and this is a size 8. Here is a close-up of the tag. Next we have this cardigan, and this kind of goes against my foundational sourcing rules. So it's just boutique. I'm not even sure what this tag says. Lily by Fermiana. And if I find boutique stuff, I like for it to have some type of aspect that elevates the quality, whether it be like a wool blend or just a really pretty print. This is 100% acrylic, which is not, you know, it's not a great fabric, but I did get this because it is the softest feeling sweater ever. I mean, you'd never know that it's 100% acrylic. It almost feels like cashmere. It is in a nice neutral color. It has these oversized tortoiseshell buttons. It's cable knit, and it's a size extra large. So it did have quite a few other sellable factors going for it. I did have to get it. It's also in that really nice kind of chunky knit. So I'll add a lot of keywords to that, try to get it sold. Next we have Zara from their Trifolic line. This is a mini dress but it's also a romper, so it looks like a dress, and you have this wrap over skirt portion, but then if you untie this, there are shorts under there, which is great. It's fully lined and it's a size large, so this should sell really well. Next we have Anthropologie. I hadn't heard of this line before, Back When by Anthropologie. I'm assuming it's just kind of like a retro kind of thing, and I love the graphic on this. It says bring joy, so I had to get it. It's like a light blue color, just a cotton crew neck sweatshirt, size small. This is an exciting find. So I mentioned, I think either last haul or a couple hauls ago, that I want to try to start picking up this brand, and this seemed like a super substantial piece within the brand. Nick and Zoe, size extra large, which is great. This is a linen blend. It has a really fun abstract print and cut. It's like high-low asymmetric hemline. And it was new with tags. So I was incredibly excited for this. The retail was $148. There's the tag. And it does say hand printed. Each unique, printed by hand, none other like it in this land. So yeah, I was very excited to see this. I got that at my Family Thrift Center outlet. Another fun kind of chunky knit boho sweater. I'm not sure where this brand is sold. I want to say Nordstrom and boutiques, like higher end boutiques. And I got this because I just thought this was adorable. It's like an oversized cable knit design with contrast trims. It's like a sweatshirt cuff and collar. So cool. I think this is a size medium, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, size medium. An item for my men's closet. I hadn't heard of this brand either. Cult of Individuality. But I was drawn to them in the bin because I saw that it said Japanese selvedge denim, which that is for sure something to look out for. Selvedge denim. These are a size 38 by 34 in the Rebel Straight, and they do have a lot of distressing, intentional fading, and wear to them, some bleaching. So I'm pretty excited for these. I'm expecting them to sell for around 75-ish in my men's closet. That's the back patch there. And if you're curious, selvedge or raw denim has the red stitching at the inside cuff. That kind of looks weird. It looks like they might have been hemmed looking at that, but it does look like it was professionally done. So I will just take pictures of that and be sure to measure the inseam. Brandy Melville. This is the Jada style dress, J-A-D-A. I have sold it so many times in the past. It usually flies out of my closet. When I very first started reselling, I picked up a ton of Brandy Melville, and it's one of those brands that has followed me until now as a, I would say, more experienced reseller. A lot of the stuff that I used to pick up, I've kind of dropped off on, but Brandy Melville, I still do pick up, mainly because it sells so fast. It does not sell for a lot, mainly because it doesn't retail for a lot, but the demand is definitely there, and I love consistent sells. So it's a black base color with like this brown kind of bleach effect. I think that's one size. This was so pretty. It's by the brand Love Stitch, which again is like a boutique kind of thing. It's a size large. Not sure why my tags are not focusing today. Size large, so pretty, very boho. It had the tie-dye and really flattering waist with the drawstring. It has side slits, or maybe not. Oh yeah, it has a middle. It slits in the middle, which is interesting. And it is long. I think this is a midi length. So really pretty. It's like a metallic gold kind of texture throughout. BDG by Urban Outfitters. This same kind of thing as the Brandy Melville. Flannels and plaid stuff from Urban Outfitters has always, since my very, very early days, sold extremely well for me. This is like an open front flannel shirt. It ties at the bottom. You can leave it untied if you'd like. Has a pleat in back, size medium. We have Tahari. I got this because it was a size extra large. It was in excellent condition. It's a cardigan cut, which cardigans are like my best selling category. And it has these really lovely kind of jewel buttons. So really nice kind of spring cardigan. Anthropologie, this is just their house line by Anthropologie, size medium. This is the tag. And it's a sleeveless midi dress. So again, great for springtime. It buttons down in front. It has the waist tie still attached. And then I'm not sure if it will pick up, but it does have a texture to it. It's supposed to look like a cross stitch, I think. I'm not sure if it's coming across on camera, but it is really pretty. Little chest pocket here. Lastly, for our first bag, this is H&M. It's an oversized chunky sweater with this really bold kind of in your face herringbone print, which I thought was super cool, very chic and modern. So I had to get that. This is a size extra large, which was another great factor. I think it's also, oh yeah, it's also a wool blend. So you have a lot happening with that. Super marketable item there. Next we have Juicy Couture, again size extra large, which is great. This is not a brand that I always get by any means, but once again, kind of like the H&M sweater, this just had a lot of sellable factors to it. So it's that cable knit design. Once again, it is a size extra large, and it is a mohair wool blend. So mohair is definitely more of a luxury fabric. Lauren Conrad, which same kind of thing. I do not pick up this brand always by any means, but I did really like this piece in particular. It's size large. It's a cheery yellow color with a striped print. And it's like a long line boyfriend cut blazer with a double-breasted kind of faux wood buttons. And to top it all off, it is 55% linen. So great springtime piece here. It's breathable, it's bright, cheery, made well, super boxy, contemporary cut, really pretty and feminine. It has some like, I don't know what you'd call this. I guess just like a ruffle kind of edge here, a little keyhole opening in back. This was missing the size tag and brand tag, but I was able to figure out it was Madewell by this interior tag. If you can see here, Madewell and J. Crew always print their style numbers, and right under the style number you will see that it says SP21. That stands for spring of 2021. So this is for sure a newer piece. That was the main reason I got it, as well as I could tell it was a larger size. This measured to be like a size extra large, so great closet staple there yet again. We have Lululemon. Always love finding this brand. The demand has definitely slowed down a little bit, but items like this, they're really soft athleisure style stuff, still sell great for me. The very kind of soft materials and sweaters. There is the logo here, and this one is actually reversible. So on the inside, you can see the logo once again. It's a solid gray inside, and this side is more of like a striped. Does have the thumb holes. I don't think I've ever picked up this brand before, Kato. I don't think it's, you know, expensive retail by any means, but this is a size 18-20. I think it is a plus size brand now that I think about it. But I just loved the style of this top. I thought it was so cute with the print and the kind of faux wrap or crossover front, paisley print. And I picked this up at the bins. It's super lightweight, so I probably only paid about like $1.50-ish for it. That'll be a good bundle item. Free People piece here. I modeled this because it is really hard to figure out what it looks like just kind of on the hanger. It's a double V, so you have V-neck in front and back. Long line with dramatic side slits on both sides, and just under the armpit you have these three faux wood buttons. So I thought this was cute. It's a size small. Tory Burch 100% merino wool button down cardigan with this ruffle trim, and the buttons do have the Tory Burch logo inside. So anything that's Tory Burch that has the logo anywhere does sell a little bit better than, you know, no logo present. So I was happy to find this. The material's great, style's great. Like I was mentioning, cardigans are one of my best selling categories. That's a size extra small. This was, once again, just kind of like a bundle piece, a grab from the bins. It's a romper blue color. It's fully lined. It ties in front. High-waisted, which is nice. A lot of people like high-waisted stuff. This is a boutique pink lily. I was actually reading about the, I guess it's creator of this brand. She's an entrepreneur, size medium. I don't think it's going to sell. I'm only expecting like maybe 15-ish from that, because I don't think that it retails for a lot. Chaps, same kind of thing. I have never picked this brand up. Actually, I take that back. Sometimes they do make really cute Southwestern sweaters, and I love anything Southwestern print, but I do not typically pick this brand up. However, I had to get this because it's a size large, and it's a striped print, button-down dress in a midi length. Midi maxi length dresses and skirts are more substantial for sure. It still had the waist tie, and I think it is all natural materials. Yes, it's a linen cotton blend. So lots of sellable factors happening with that. More Chicos. These are the exact same blouse. So I did go ahead and get them. I found them both at the bins. And if I find two of the exact same item, I'm more likely to get it, even if it's just like a plain, more plain item like this. This is a good bundled piece once again. And I'm more likely to get them because it's just way easier to list them. I can list one and then copy and paste everything for the second listing. So, you know, it's like I have to do no work for that second listing, which is great. So yeah, this has a really light texture to it with a, it's like a tiered ruffle sleeve, and this one is the exact same, but it's a size 3. So I think this one is extra large and that one is extra extra large. This was another top that I modeled just because it's definitely more flattering on than off. I hadn't heard of this, the Refinery, size small, but I did like this kind of dramatic draped front, and it's also in a slub cotton, which is super popular. That is keywords slub cotton. It's just like a more like lightweight kind of gauzy, if you can see that to the material there. That's a slub. That's what slub cotton looks like. Brands like James Percy and Wilt, brands like that, use a lot of slub cotton and they sell really well. So yeah. Oh, it's also a modal blend, which is, like I was mentioning earlier, very soft, very nice. Moving on, we have another bins grab. I got this as a closet filler kind of bundle item. I like that it was tie-dye and a jumpsuit. Both of those characteristics sell great for me. Tie-dye print and rompers or jumpsuits. It has a flattering waist with the drawstring. The size tag is missing, but I think it's like a size small. I will add athleisure, lounge, tie-dye, jumpsuit, boho keywords to that. The limited, which I feel like I've said this a million times in this haul, but I do not get this brand always at all. But this was a size large and it was a long line. Excuse me, train. It was a long line cardigan that still had the attached waist belt. You have that cable knit once again. And to top it all off, it is a mohair blend. Yes, 46% wool and 5% mohair. So it has that really like luxurious kind of fuzzy texture to it. And this green color is really pretty. It's a nice earth tone. We have Angie, I believe. Yes, Angie, I do like to get this as, once again, a closet filler slash bundle item. But this is elevated a little bit because it is a size 1X and it's a maxi dress. It also is in a very boho kind of print and color palette. It has lace trims throughout. So this is an item that would have retailed for a bit higher, which means that it should resell for a bit higher. So it does have a lot of thoughtful details like adjustable straps. So yeah, very excited about this. Very excited that it was a 1X. Cabbie, I debated on this piece at the bins because this is their older tag from Cabbie. The newer tag is a square. And I really tried to avoid this older tag, but I love this. I picked it up and then put it down like 5 different times, but in the end, I absolutely could not leave it because the style is just so cute. So this is the print. It's once again, longer length, kind of a bold floral print with the waist tie still there, and it's actually reversible. So on the other side, you have a black and white floral print, and obviously the belt crosses over to the other side. You have the black and white print, but then on the underside you have the colorful print. So I thought this was so cute, and you know, if you find a reversible item and the tag is still attached on the other side, that usually means that it was either not worn or it just wasn't worn you know, on the opposite side, because you know, the tag would have been showing. So that's kind of a good tip. Also, if you find a reversible item and you can't find the tag, always check the pockets because they usually hide it in there. Okay, another one of my favorite kind of mid-tier boutique brands, this is Umji. And I got this once again for a mixture of reasons. It's a size large. It's a striped print. It has this ruffle sleeve, very boho, asymmetric hemline, and an embroidered floral design. So this has a lot happening. I thought it would be a nice kind of statement top, but also, you know, it's not that statement because it's still like earth tones and, you know, it's not so in your face. More Brandy Melville, same kind of thing as earlier. This should sell very quickly, not for a lot. Anytime the floral print is very small like this, you want to use the keyword ditzy floral because that is like a 90s keyword. A lot of stuff from the 90s was made with ditzy floral prints, Y2K stuff, and it's definitely something that people are searching for. Another brand that I don't think retailed for a lot, you guys will see, I know throughout this haul I have had a lot of kind of bread and butter stuff. This is what happens when it's a slower bins day. I still have to get items, and so I'm picking up stuff that may not be the best brand or have the highest retail price, but it does have a lot of sellable features to it. So I try to explain those out when I can. This one, it was the plaid print with this bleached design. I will add keywords like grunge, plaid, bleach, peplum. It buttons down on the top half. So really cute. It's a size small, very boho. It's like boho grunge, I would say. It's another item for my men's closet. This is Bonobos, just a new attacks button down shirt. It was totally new in package. I did take it out to photograph it, but I just stuck it right back in. It's the brushed button down in gray heather slim fit, and it's a size extra large. So that should go for, I would say, 25 to 30 ish. Another new attacks item, Angie once again. And this has a lot going for it. Very boho, floral print, off shoulder romper with a bell sleeve. More chicos. This was missing the tag, the neck tag, but I did see on the interior tag that it was chicos. I actually found it at the bins in a stack of someone's donations, and they were primarily chicos, so I had a big hint there. But this style of top or sweater has always sold great for me. The kind of layered look where, you know, you get like a chic layered effect, but you don't have to put any thought into it because this is built in. It's a cotton white shirt tail with this really soft, stretchy, heathered gray sweatshirt over top. I think that measured like a size extra, extra large. J. Crew, size 12, which is awesome. Floral print dress. This is a faux wrap look dress, so crossover front, and then it does have some ruffles. I'm not sure if you guys can see that. Yeah, at the bottom hem, so cute. This is a great springtime piece from summer 2018. Just a lounge sweatshirt here. This is Old Navy, size extra small. I don't always get Old Navy, of course, but athleisure stuff, loungewear stuff has been huge. So I did get this. I think it will sell very quickly, not for a lot, but I like selling stuff quickly. And it had that tie-dye print to it. More Anthropology. This is from Meadow Rue in a size extra small petite. Really cute, like nubby knit textured sweater with a stripe print and a little keyhole closure in back. Next, I think this is Altered State. This is the same kind of, it's in line with Umji. It's like a mid-tier boutique, which I do like to get when they have more substantial items like this. Size small. This is a jumpsuit with a stripe print. Once again, you do have that keyhole opening here with a little tie. It's a high-waisted jumpsuit. And I mean, this thing is definitely substantial. It has like the flyaway leg. It has some weight to it. And I mean, this is so cute. I will add beach, coastal, nautical, summer, all kinds of stuff, keywords. It zips in back. And so yeah, I was definitely happy finding this. I think it's 100%, yeah, 100% cotton. This was a brand I had never found before, but I have been wanting to. I keep hearing about how well and quickly it sells. Viori. It's a size large, and this is a men's t-shirt. It's just a long sleeve heathered gray t-shirt. So I'll throw this over in my men's closet. Probably, I need to do research, but probably around 30-ish. These are from Target, and size who, what, where. I will get Target stuff, especially if I'm at the bins or, you know, an outlet store, and they have a lot going for them. So these are size 12, which is great. They're that trendy gingham print once again. They're high-waisted, which is a very popular cut. They have the paper bag waist, which is basically just when you have the tie here and then it's ruffled above that. And they also are a linen blend. Let me see, where's the tag? I'm almost positive that they are though. They also looked brand new. They still have the kind of tag stuff there. Okay, I know for a fact that, oh yeah, okay, it's on the size tag. 55% linen. One of my favorite brands to pick up. I would say this brand goes along with Chico's, Soft Surroundings, J. Jill, and it is Logo by Lori Goldstein. Definitely sells very quickly and consistently for me, especially in the larger sizes with fun prints. So this hits everything because it's a size 3X. It has a fun, colorful floral print with a shark bite hem. And I actually found two of them. This is the same kind of thing, size 3X. I love this one. It's like an ombre with a lace trim. And this one actually has pockets. So super cute, very boho. Another kind of boutique piece. This was new with tags. And it also was a very neutral kind of earth tone piece. It's a romper, which I was saying, rompers sell great for me. It has a button up detail. It's fully lined and then it has little ties at the shoulders. So quite a bit going for this. It has that kind of gum strip here to keep it in place at the chest, which is great. Has the side zip. And I think this actually was also a linen blend. Yeah, 70% cotton, 30% linen. So all natural materials. I am definitely not afraid to get boutique stuff when it has a lot of selling factors. This is the exact same kind of thing. I see this brand a lot, Urban Romantics. I want to say it's sold at maybe even like TJ Maxx, but this was again linen and cotton, and it was a really cute cut and style. So I went ahead and got it. It's a button down midi dress with a slit in front. So cute. Again, I'll add beach, coastal, spring, summer. More Chico's. The brand tag is missing, but I did confirm at the interior tag. Really bold tiger print button down shirt. This measured like a size extra, extra large, which is great. So I think that should do really well. I love finding animal print stuff. It sells fantastically. We have True Religion, which this is a brand that some people will only wear. Some people will only wear Miss Me, True Religion, Buckle. There's quite a few, but they are brands that have a solid audience to them. And so I did want to get this, not only for that reason, but also because of the style and material. This is an alpaca blend. It has lots of manufactured distressing and that really nice kind of fuzzy material due to the alpaca and mohair. So I had to grab that. Really cute mod cloth printed button-down shirt. I love finding mod cloth stuff. Once again, kind of like True Religion, it does have a very consistent following, fan base, customer. This is a little retro floral printed shirt. How cute would this be tucked into like medium wash, super high rise jeans? I think that would be adorable. Matilda Jane. This is actually very similar to what I was just talking about. Matilda Jane has a very strong customer base. They make clothing that, you know, mom can wear and daughter can wear. So, you know, you can match your child. And a lot of people, you know, are super into that. They have a lot of clothing from this brand specifically. And I thought this was so cute. It's like a peasant boho style dress with some lace details and a neutral floral print. It's a little bit longer length in a size medium. Even more Chicos. I feel like I've had so much Chicos. These are a great find though. They're Nua tags. And again, they're a super sellable kind of cut and style. They are 100% linen. They're called the Easy Pant in a size extra large. And they have a one button closure, wide leg, and a natural kind of cream color. So just a great closet staple. You can wear those to the beach, you can wear those at home, running errands. Torrid, very solid bread and butter seller for me. It's a plus size brand and this is 2X. Anything substantial from Torrid sells great. This should go for 30 to 35-ish. It's a green utility style lightweight jacket. I think this is 100% cotton. This is just the brand Millennium, which I had never heard of, but it was a size extra large. Tie-dye print, it's a maxi dress, and it still had the waist tie. The back has a super cute keyhole closure with the tassel detail. So this has a lot happening. I can do a lot of keywords once again with it being a size extra large. That's great. And our very last item, this was a bins pickup that I could not leave behind just because I loved the print and style of it. It's just Easel Los Angeles, size large. How cute is this? I can add prairie, boho, cottagecore, floral print, dolman sleeve, or I guess that's more of a batwing sleeve. But yeah, really pretty kind of earth tone colors to that. Alrighty, so that is absolutely everything in this haul. That was over 90 items. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did enjoy, please feel free to leave me a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you guys soon. Bye, y'all.